It's no secret that running multiple applications simultaneously slows down a computer, and games, in particular, begin to lag noticeably. But why do some programs or cheats significantly affect performance, while others have almost no impact on the system? Today, we'll explore the main factors that influence FPS stability. In this video, we've hidden Easter eggs with subscription activation codes and are also launching a giveaway for commenters. To participate, like the video, subscribe to the channel, and leave a meaningful comment, including your Never Lose nickname at the end. Let's continue. The thing is, without understanding the basics of how code runs on actual hardware, it's hard to evaluate the causes of a cheat's unstable performance, delays, or performance drops. By understanding the process from writing code to its execution on a PC, viewers can better grasp why different cheats behave differently on various systems. This knowledge helps explain how hardware, optimization, and algorithms affect game quality and experience. A cheat is not a mystical entity, but a regular program written in a programming language. When launched, like any utility or game, it is loaded into RAM and executed by the processor. The processor sequentially executes the instructions laid out in the cheat, whether they involve calculating damage, determining the enemy's position, or bypassing protection. Thus, a cheat is fundamentally no different from other programs. It is also limited by processor performance, hardware architecture, and the efficiency of the written code. Today, we'll discuss these issues in more detail. Let's start with the basics. Different lines of code load the system differently, depending on the set of assembly instructions and their complexity. Some lines of code call multiple functions, slowing down the program and requiring more processor power, thereby reducing performance. Code functions logically the same across all systems, but different processors handle it at different speeds. For instance, AMD Bulldozer processors perform calculations slower due to their design. Thus, even processors in the same price range can handle various tasks differently. This has led to a long-standing community joke. If you want your cheat to work as efficiently as the coders, get the same processor they have. Of course, it's a joke, but there's some truth to it. Complex calculations can place a heavy load on the processor, especially if it has to share a block for mathematical operations between multiple cores. But what task in cheats is typically the most CPU intensive? Tracing. What's that for? Let's first define what tracing is. Essentially, it involves sending a ray from point A to point B. In cheats, this is used to simulate a shot's trajectory. The ray moves forward, and each collision with a surface triggers checks. What is the material of the obstacle? Its thickness. The angle of impact. Will the ray penetrate the object? If it does, how much damage will drop? Each collision must be accounted for until the ray either reaches its target or the bullet's damage is exhausted. The most important thing for a rage bot is to deal damage to enemies as efficiently as possible. Hence, tracing plays a critical role. This may seem like a simple task for a computer, but the devil is in the details. For greater accuracy, the client sends rays to all selected enemy hitboxes: the head, body, arms, and legs. The cheat must also account for multipoints on each hitbox and send traces to each of them. Each additional aimpoint requires sending a new ray. But that's not all. Additional scanning and backtracking of the enemy are required. The maximum preset multiplies the number of scanned backtrack models of the enemy up to 10. All these must also be scanned, with traces sent to all multipoints, damage calculated, hit probability assessed, and many other parameters considered. As a result, the number of traces per enemy per second in our product can reach several thousand. Unsurprisingly, with a large number of enemies on the map, the total number of traces can become excessive, significantly impacting performance. This brings us to a crucial aspect: optimization. To ensure the game doesn't turn into a slideshow, even with one enemy, developers continuously improve their code. First, the programmer tackles the task head-on, writing the function simply to make it work. Once functionality is achieved, the refactoring phase begins, rewriting the code to make it more elegant, compact, and efficient. The developer always considers the hardware specifics on which the program will run. Processors from different manufacturers and even models of various generations, such as the Ryzen 5700X and Intel Core i5-12600K, which were similarly priced at their time, can differ significantly in logic and optimization mechanisms. An experienced programmer knows multiple ways to solve a problem. In beginner projects, optimization issues often arise due to the developer's lack of experience. Novices frequently use inefficient algorithms without understanding their principles or possible alternatives. The developer must look under the hood. What exactly does the compiler turn the code into? How many assembly instructions result? A good programmer uses profilers, tools that show which lines of code consume the most time and create bottlenecks. Analyzing profiler data reveals where the game lags and what needs improvement. Additionally, static analyzers and stress testing provide a deeper understanding of performance and application stability. It's also crucial to distribute computations over time. Imagine you have a large to-do list and try to complete everything in 1 second. It's overwhelming. But if you spread tasks over several seconds, alternating between difficult and easy ones, overall performance improves. Similarly, in games, complex operations are spread across frames or delegated to separate threads to avoid slowing down the main game process. However, developers must be cautious. Over-optimization can make code harder to understand and maintain. This is especially critical in large projects involving many developers. Striking a balance between optimization and code readability is key to successful development. Code must be both efficient and comprehensible. Just as engineers design cars to be both fast and easy to service, developers should avoid excessive optimizations. Overly complex code increases the risk of future errors, and fixing them can take much longer due to the non-intuitive structure. Neglecting the balance between readability and optimization can quickly turn project development into chaos. Now let's talk about the main optimization methods. Compilation is not just code translation, but also optimization. Modern compilers automatically improve code by removing unnecessary variables and simplifying complex commands to make programs run faster. For instance, a compiler can replace lengthy mathematical operations with faster equivalents or combine multiple steps into one. Compiler optimization is akin to streamlining a delivery route to make it faster and more cost-effective without altering the final destination. The compiler optimizes the code to execute efficiently while preserving its functionality. However, automatic optimizations can sometimes cause issues. In the past, compilers inadvertently exposed sensitive data, such as cryptographic keys, due to their optimizations. This happened because optimizations altered the order or method of data storage, making it accessible to attackers. Such cases highlight that while optimizations are generally beneficial, they can occasionally introduce serious vulnerabilities. Thus, it's sometimes necessary to examine the resulting assembly code to understand how the compiler has transformed the source code, and to identify potential problems caused by these optimizations. Beyond compiler optimizations, choosing the right algorithms is crucial. An algorithm's efficiency is measured by how quickly it solves a problem as the data volume increases. For example, bubble sort is slow for large datasets, whereas quicksort handles the same amount of data much faster. Sometimes, precise algorithms are too slow for large tasks. In such cases, approximation methods are used, which provide fast but approximate solutions. Choosing the right algorithm or approximation method can significantly reduce the execution time of both cheats and any other program. It's like quick cleaning a room. You skip some details to finish faster, achieving a good enough result in less time. Algorithmic optimization is one of the most critical methods for improving program efficiency. Compared to compiler-level or code-level optimizations, selecting the right algorithm often has a greater impact on a cheat's performance. Processors have multiple cores, enabling them to perform several tasks simultaneously. Using parallel computations and multi-threading can significantly boost application performance. For instance, in a cheat, hit scans for each player can be handled in separate threads, while saving and loading settings can be moved to another thread. Resource-intensive tasks not directly interacting with gameplay, such as server communication or retrieving new chat messages, can be delegated to background threads. Another common approach is parallelizing computations, effectively utilizing modern processors' capabilities. Proper multi-threading requires meticulous planning to avoid conflicts and distribute the workload efficiently. It's like an orchestra where each musician plays their part simultaneously under the conductor's guidance. If someone plays out of sync, the entire symphony falls apart. Exploring optimization techniques is an endless pursuit, so it's impossible to cover all existing methods. In this video, we've highlighted only the most intriguing ones. Those interested in this topic can easily find suitable methods independently, as there are numerous books and articles on the subject. In the world of software development, whether for games, applications, or cheats, it all boils down to a delicate balance. Code starts as simple text, becomes a set of processor instructions, and is then refined through refactoring and optimizations to become faster, more powerful, and efficient. However, not all developers adhere to best practices. Poor quality code can lead to performance degradation, increased bugs, and complicate future project maintenance. These issues often stem from a lack of experience, haste, or misunderstanding of clean code principles. It's always important to remember that achieving perfect performance at the expense of simplicity is impractical. The main goal is to strike the golden mean between speed, usability, and reliability. Thank you for watching. Share your thoughts in the comments. You might notice something we missed. Also, let us know what you'd like to learn about in the future. Good luck! This has been the Never Lose Team.